Hello and welcome to episode 56, not 55, not 54, 56. We're getting there. I really would just look forward to 100, but whatever.
That
we're
might be
at
next
56.
Year.
Nah.
That might be next year.
No, probably 2 years.
About 2 years. Yeah, it could be
so
two
this
years.
Is our special happy birthday episode number 2. And so this is our second Podaversary.
Yeah.
My name is Debbie. I'm Deb's Destiny on Ravelry and Instagram and probably something else too, but Deb's Destiny. And this is.
And I'm Blue Yarn Always on Ravelry and Instagram, and it's January 14th. And we've been podcasting for 2 years.
We have. I can't believe it. Oh my gosh. We've made so many cool friends.
We have.
And you know what I find the most amazing? Sheila doesn't mind admitting she's my friend after 2 years.
Oh, give me a break.
So, yeah, thank you for putting up with me. You're a good friend.
Oh, you're welcome. Here, I got us some bubbly so we can, you're going to get your cup. So cheers. And maybe we go one more year and see how it goes.
No, maybe we go maybe 10 more years.
Okay, well, there you go. As long as we like doing this, we'll keep doing this.
I think that sounds good.
Okay.
That's how we started.
So you know. Raise your teacup. Cheers.
Cheers.
I love cream soda. That was cream soda.
Cream soda. It really is good.
Mm-hmm. It is. I don't know if people can get it in their area.
Yeah. It's a special Faygo type of thing for
Faygo pop.
Yeah.
For Michigan.
So that was really exciting for us. Oh my gosh. And for you guys too. I can't believe you guys are watching us for 2 years. Oh my gosh, you rock.
Yeah, and if you've been a subscriber for 2 years, God love you.
Yeah, seriously.
So, besides our 2 year anniversary, The Biggest Loser is still going on. So, if you have joined The Biggest Loser Stash Reduction Challenge, January thread is in the Fiber Pusher podcast. That's where you should be posting all your finished objects with how much grams you're losing. And if you bought yarn or received yarn, you need to post that in there as a gain. In February, at the podcast that we have here, the group on Ravelry, we will post the February thread. So keep posting all your objects in Benita's group in the Fiber Pusher podcast for January. We are February.
Yep, Benita, you rock.
Yeah. Oh, and in order to celebrate our 2 year anniversary.
Podaversary.
Podaversary, anniversary, birthday.
Thingy my Bob.
That's right. Our 2 year barbecue. Our 2 years of yarn winding. We're going to do a giveaway. We were given this bag by Kim, who is chasing acorns.
Thank you, Kim.
Yes, thank you so much. This cute little bag got a nice handle on it, and it's got these snaps on the bottom. So you can make it a flat bag. Or yeah, this is really clever. Am I good with snaps? Yes, I am.
Oh, cool.
Or it's just a regular sack bag. Got a nice handle on it. She's got a drawstring on here. So we're going to open up a thread in the group. We don't know what the question is. But if you're interested in winning our 2 year birthday present, compliments to Kim. Oh, is that a deer? That's an actual animal on there.
Oh, that's so cute.
I just now noticed that.
I'll let them see.
It's like mosaic. Ain't that cute?
That's so classy.
So we're going to put this up for a prize, and we'll draw next podcast. But guess what we're drawing for? The winner didn't claim it. The winner, this is V Yarn. The winner did not claim this. I did not hear from her, not a peep. So somebody's going to get this today. If you contact me and we draw your name, it's Lightning Dust. So this was the thread that was in Ravelry for the V Yarn giveaway. So we had how many entries? You got your handy dandy machine on? 2 through 27.
And what was the number for the one that did not?
I believe we cannot pick number 23.
sure that it was. Was it 23? I have it written down. Let's see.
No pressure. Okay, so while you're looking, I'm going to tell a story. This morning, my husband decided to take my car, and I've never had automatic start on my car, so it was actually quite interesting that he was, like, all gung-ho. He had to get it done, and, you know, I'm like, oh, that's kind of cool, you know, making me feel special and everything like that. And so he gets this, he goes to the store and brings it home, and he was trying to tell me how to use it, because now there's two like keypads and you're not supposed to use the factory one, but you have to use the one that's now an alarm start, whatever. So this new start thing, you have to use that one. Do not use the factory one.
Do not.
Just don't go there.
This isn't really quite. There we go.
That
was bothering me.
Okay. So, he ends up, going and doing some errands and stuff like that. And so I'm like, okay, I gotta go to Sheila's. So I go get the thing out and I'm like trying to press it and it's not starting. And when I call him to say it's not starting, what's going on with it? I realized that, well, the battery's probably dead on it and that's why. And so there's nothing I can do for that. So I'm like, okay, well, I can still drive the car because I have my factory start thing.
Factory remote.
Yeah. So I go outside and I hit the door open on the one that's always worked for the past, I don't know, 6 months since I've had the car. And what happens? Ooh, my word.
No. You're waking up the neighborhood.
Oh, well, thank goodness it's not early in the morning. You know, you never know. Some people could be sleeping and like, so. It just was like, oh, dear goodness, I can't even start my car now. I can't drive it anywhere because it killed the engine. And it's like, oh, dear goodness. So that's my life. That's how I live my life. And that's just the type of things that I do. And you know what? If you can't laugh at yourself, who can you laugh at?
That's true. That is okay. True.
So what was the number?
I believe it was a number 23. We're not looking for number 23.
Okay.
So we got through 2 through 27. Winner, winner.
Chicken dinner.
10. Ooh, somebody's gaining weight.
Uh-oh. Who is it?
Number 10 is LDS Venus. Who is?
Oh, she's an active.
Shh, no name.
She's an active.
No name.
She's active. She's going to contact us.
Venus.
I really think she is. She's very active in our group.
Okay. So you have till February 14th, the day of love, to PM me for this skein of yarn from V Yarns.
Oh,
and so it's LDS Venus.
Go ahead and go send her your address. Don't make her ask for it. Just go ahead and send it to her.
Send me all your stuff, and I can get in the post office to you next week.
Yeah.
Terrific.
No.
So that's less yarn we have to hold on to.
Oh, less for us. I bet you, she's pretty active in our group. I would bet she's probably in the Biggest Loser competition.
I don't know. I've been posting for the Biggest Loser. You've been posting?
Have not posted yet, but I'm going to take pictures because I have some stuff to add in there. And then I will go ahead and upload that today. I know I have to the end of the month, but I don't want to wait to the end of the month.
Yeah, I have so many project pages now where stuff that I want to make. So I like made project pages, but I haven't picked the yarn. I haven't done anything yet. Mm-mm. Nothing. So, you want to move on to escapees.
Go ahead.
Don't hurt yourself. That was a fast, go ahead.
No. Okay. I mean, are you guys really surprised? I mean, I'm not. Are you really surprised? I don't have anything.
They could be surprised. They could. Well, I made two of these artfully simple infinity scarves.
So this is just acrylic yarn.
That's pretty.
And I believe this was the Vanna white color. And I didn't use the full skein because it got like yarn barf and I just kind of balled it up and threw it in the garbage. So I think this wasn't even 100 grams. It was like, I don't know. It's posted in the group. But this is a cute little cowl and it's going to go in the gift bucket. So that's one done. The second is the same pattern. Now this is for a coworker that asked me to make this for her. And this yarn is, let me see. And it's pretty. Really nice soft acrylic. This one is Red Heart Unforgettable stained glass.
It feels like mohair.
So if you're a crocheter, this would be something quick and simple to give as a gift to somebody. I made this Mobius, of course. And then here's the little, the finisher didn't finish, but you kind of like loop it around.
Oh!
Put a little button there if you'd like.
Cool.
But it's a nice cowl, and to do it in variegated yarn is much nicer, I believe, than to do it in plain yarn. And of course, I made this on a bigger size needle and this one on a smaller size needle.
Okay.
So both crocheted projects that I finished up and finished my project page. And then there's a thread on our group for posting all your objects. It's like, it's going to be like a photo book. It's a non-prize thread. There's no prize. But that way I can keep track besides putting tags on my Ravelry page for 2017. Like, this would be good for you because you don't do project pages. So you could just post all your pictures like right in there.
Okay.
It's a non-prize thread. It's kind of like park your grams here. And then you just post your pictures. Keep editing and put them in. Okay. And at the end of the year, you'll see like everything you made.
Okay.
If you don't keep a project page.
Right. I keep meaning to. When I do knit-alongs, I do the project pages. And then if I'm doing a pattern of my own, then I'll do that too. But yeah, I should do more of those.
Are we a project page?
I should do more project pages.
I did make crochet a ribbed bun hat, but that's already left the house. I didn't even put it in for the Biggest Loser. Now, that was crocheted, and that was for my sister, and it was a free pattern on Ravelry, but the secret to that bun hat was a black elastic rubber band that went at the top, and you crocheted in it every time you passed it, and that expanded the top of the messy bun hat so you could pull your hair out. It was a black rubber band.
Oh,
is that interesting?
Oh, so that's actually in the hat, the
rubber band. Yep. It's in the hole.
Oh, my word.
Because as I'm looking at the pattern, I'm like, how is that going to stretch to get the hair up in there? And you actually had to get a coated rubber band. And every time you worked up, because this was worked side to side like a typewriter. So every time I went up, I latched onto the rubber band. Then I came back down. And then I went up, and then I latched onto the rubber band. So at the top, when I was all done, you could open it up like this far. It was huge.
Wow.
So that's gone.
That's so cool.
Yeah. She likes it. And then the last thing is the hitchhiker for Jennifer, who lives in Tennessee. So I'm going to ship this back to her. And this was made out of Fresh from the Cauldron MCN sock. And the colorway is Styx. There's no great pooling on this at all. But
which
I mean,
we all know Sheila likes.
I do like it. But the yarn was just incredible. I mean, who doesn't like working with MCN? Some merino, some cashmere.
It's very soft.
Yeah. So this is going to the finisher as soon as she comes back because she left today. She left. So two things are going out of the house. And then this one's going to go in the Christmas bucket. So two things are out. So I did make a teacup that I posted on Instagram. Did I post it on Instagram?
I think I just have a problem here.
I don't know, but I don't have it with me this week, but it was a crocheted teacup. And if anything, I'll save it for, I'll show you next week. And that was pretty easy to do with cotton yarn, and it'd make great gifts for like the tea drinker.
That is really, it's really cute.
Yeah, it's really, really cute. You know what? I gotta enter this into the Knit From Your Library, Cal, in the Flame and Fiber podcast. I just thought about that. Barb and Sharon of Moms with Yarn. Well, I gotta do Sharon's too. Are having a Cal. It's called Knit From Your Library. And of course, I have The Hitchhiker in my library. So I am going to, maybe I should post this too, because I got this in my life. I don't know. But they're having a Cal called Knit From Your Library, and it's the Flame and Fiber podcast and Moms with Yarn podcast. So check out those two ladies. They're really
Flaming
fun.
Fiber.
The Flaming? Flaming Fiber. Flame and Fiber podcast and Moms with Yarn. Sharon's amazing, but this Barb who runs the Flame and Fiber podcast, boy, I just like how she thinks.
Really?
I just do. She's just like blunt, right to the point, like, it's the way it is. And then she just moves on. I think it's great.
Yeah, I beat around the bush sometimes.
No beating around the bush.
Drives somebody up the wall.
Oh, we got a cat down here chewing on the ribbons from the...
Oh, no.
Oh, come on.
Hi, baby.
She's pulling on the ribbons.
Hi, baby. Come here, you.
She's like, you took me away from my fun.
Oh, look at the baby kitty girl. Oh, she just...
She's not no baby.
Oh, the little kitty. Oh.
But I think that's all I have.
She's just so... You can just squish her a little bit, and she doesn't mind.
No. Aww.
She doesn't mind being handled. My kitties really mind being handled.
They don't like being held? No. Oh, she likes being held.
Oh.
She does. She likes
so
being held.
Cute. Oh.
It's like a big fluffy ball.
Look at how cute she is. Hi there.
Okay. So we got getting your knitting on. Oh no, hanging on the wire. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Hanging on the wire.
I still have my knit alone going on.
A knit alone? Never heard of it. How does that work? How does that work?
Well, I guess it was too... I don't know. I guess you'll have to help me on that because I don't know. I was thinking, well, you know what? I'm really stressed out before Christmas. And I'm like, let me try and do something excessively brain dead just because that's all I can handle. Mm-hmm. Now it's boring. Because I can handle more, and I'm not quite as brain dead. So I put a thread up that was like excessively easy knitting, and just it's going to be a cowl. And what I did is I pulled out some yarn that I had, and it was three of purple and one of green, and I just figured everybody's got to have some, well, maybe not everybody, but if you're like me, you're going to have some, but bought something on clearance or got a really good deal, and they don't really match, and you just haven't found the right thing, and you just really want to do something, so here's a really easy, real easy pattern just to go ahead and use yarn that's the same kind, but different colors.
Mm-hmm.
And so I put the pattern up there. It's not test knit. It's not written out like my normal patterns. It's on the bias. So when it's done, it'll be going sideways. And it'll have a kind of a cool stripe to it. So this is what I'm doing. And I put it up there just thinking, well, maybe somebody else might want to. And nobody has. So,
So that's why it's a knit alone.
It's a knit alone.
She is doing or conducting a knit alone.
Yeah, so
please do not join the thread.
Yeah, please don't join.
It's a knit alone. She wants to knit this alone. You know what? Okay. I won't even knit it either.
You weren't gonna.
I won't knit it either.
Oh my gosh.
I won't. I will support your knit alone.
Thank you for supporting my knit alone.
I will.
Okay, and I just have this like thing that's like all. Okay, it's so I've got this one going on, and I Because of the knot, I have to put this one down and pick a different pattern, and it's going to get me sidetracked and not speaking very well right now. So
be careful. She's a biter. What? She's a biter. Like the cat.
The yarn?
The cat, if she sees yarn, she'll bite it. She won't. She's a biter.
Okay. So this is my Aunt Joan's that poncho that I'm working on. This is Muscari, and, this is my Aunt Joan's yarn, and then Muscari, this is a free pattern on, Ravelry, and, I'm off pattern a little bit, and I don't care, I'm good with that. I'm going from light to dark, so this is going to be my next color, and you can see that it's quite darker than the first one that I started, so it's just getting progressively darker, so by the time I get to the bottom, it'll be much darker than the top, and nobody will notice. Okay, so, oh my goodness.
Oh, they jumped.
They do. They jump right off.
They jumped.
Okay, so I will start working on that one. And then I meant to bring the book, but the book tends to get heavy, so I just copy the pages out of the book that I own. I'm working on a sleeveless tunic called Storm.
You could so enter these into that cal. And they're from your library.
Yeah. And so this is a book that I've had for probably a few years. But with The Biggest Loser, it's something that I've
wanted to make.
This is like chunkier yarn. And it's also, I really want to make something that when I get a job that I'm working professionally, that I can actually wear stuff that I've actually made. And
you want to wear your stuff to work.
I do. So I'm making this one. And I'm making it out of got that one, but where's the other one?
Rush.
Mountain Color Yarns. Bozeman
Wool.
100% wool.
And then this one here, Lush.
Yep.
Are you using Lush?
The black is Lush.
Oh.
And the red one is the
Angora and Wool.
Yeah, so then this is Mountain Colors, and this is the Angora. So right next to my skin will be nice and soft and snuggly. And this is one of the front sides.
What's the color? It's called Ruby River.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is Ruby.
There wasn't enough do it solely with just the red.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I put some of it with the black. And I thought, you know what? Just doing black is, I'm not going to do that. But if it's so something
you have Angora and sheep on you. So you're going to have Angora and wool.
Yep.
That's nice. Look at this needle size, 15 to 17.
Yep.
Holy smoly. And that's the recommended needle size.
17.
Wow.
Yep. And the pattern's for a 17 needle size, too. So I'm done with one side of it. I'm working on the other side. I really
hope. The front panel?
Yeah. So this is the second front panel. I really want to have the back done. And I really want to have it done this month so I can enter it into Benita's group for this month.
For January?
Yeah. And it's the 14th.
It's the 14th. Do we have 31 days this month or 30?
Yeah,
31.
So I need
Time. You could do it. You got big needles, chunky yarn.
Yeah, I should be halfway done.
Yeah.
I'm not.
You could do it.
I can.
You could do it. What do I got for hanging on the wire?
So that's it for hanging on the wire for me.
I have two things. First one is this sock, which there's no hurry. This is a sock blank that I dyed with Kool-Aid last year. This is what I got left. And then this is the other ball here. So I think it was blueberry Kool-Aid and red Kool-Aid. And I just used a stencil
and just played around with it on the counter. But these are on my Chagu's, and it's just my standard, just vanilla sock. Just something to keep busy. She keep biting on the ribbon. And then I started the butterfly shawl for Debbie.
Thank you.
I did. It's a crochet. It's a free pattern. Can I just say, look at that charting. I love it. That's what I'm reading now. I'm not even reading the text. I'm going off the chart. So she wound up all the yarn. And this is Stonehenge, I believe.
Yes.
And in the pattern, it says pick your needle. So, of course, I picked my needle. My favorite size is G for go. I'm not that far because I started it last night at our Christmas party. I know you would ask, why are you having a Christmas party on Friday the 13th? But last night was our Christmas party. And I started this there. And let me drop this needle here. I am this far. I don't know if you can see the butterfly yet. Can you put your hand behind there? Can you see the butterflies? You can see the butterflies, can't you? There you go. So I got two butterflies already. So I need a whole flock. But that's where I am so far. This will be a little bit, but Debbie's in no hurry.
I'm not.
But those are the two that I have hanging on the wire. You're making a friend.
I am. Okay, so floor is now safe from little kitty so that she cannot get that in her mouth, the string. She's going to pop.
The ribbon. She doesn't have front nails, so I don't think.
Like,
she's
going to
pop.
Like, oh, Nellie, poor kitty's cat.
Do you got anything for getting your knitting on?
I have some ideas that I'm thinking about, but I'm clearly going to be finishing what I'm doing now first. Mm-hmm. But I was looking at this lace scarf, and these are free on Ravelry. She wants her mommy.
Oh, no, okay, she wants the floor. What is that, the lace cuffs?
Yeah, simple lace cuffs.
It can go in your sleeve. Is that chunky?
I don't know.
Sport weight?
No, not chunky.
Nope.
I just figured it would be something easy to just do a quick whatever. My, I'm tall.
You can't. No, really?
Yeah, well, they don't know. They can't see me standing.
Am I all the way down? There.
In real life, I'm a little taller. I know. But I'm tall, so
like
everything is always too short, so it just would be cool to have some sort of a lace something to have it so that that's longer. And I was on Ravelry a lot this week, and last week. Jong is another one that I'm thinking about doing. And this is going, I'm not going to start this one until I'm done with
The storm.
Yeah. Because this is chunky too. So it's a different a build than some of the other ones that I have. But it looks so comfortable. And then I keep looking at this Old Town shawl. It's got a little bit of lace in it. And it's got a little bit of cabling. And it's just so pretty. But I'm not ready to cast on this one yet either. Maybe next month when the pressure's off a little bit. Because, you know, I can't win.
You feel pressure?
No.
Oh. I feel no pressure because it's not October or November. You shouldn't feel pressure. This is supposed to be fun.
Yeah, I know that. But if it's like I'm trying to get that done by the end of the month so I can put in a Benita's thread. Because if I finish it our month, then I can't.
You're disqualified.
You know, yeah, but
I'll
I don't even know.
I'll have to delete your post.
Then I might have to put another one in there. So, no, I can't win in ours. But, you know, and it's even questionable whether or not I should be able to win in
in Benita's, but I just really want to post something in Benita's group. Okay, so.
You can post.
Another one is Best Friend Mitts, and that's by our friend Debbie Lake. She is really a wonderful designer. Her patterns are so easy to understand, and it's just, it's a very nice, her things are just so easy. So,
she's a Michigan designer.
She is.
Guess who else is a Michigan designer?
I don't know.
What is all the rage on Ravelry and Instagram? What shop?
Find your fade.
Find your fade. Guess where that designer lives?
Michigan.
Yes. Congratulations to Andrea.
And congrats. Definitely.
I know a Michigander who is like so popular with knitters. It's unbelievable. Congratulations to her.
Good job. Good job.
Yes. Another Michigan designer.
Okay. So what items are you thinking about?
Doing?
Yeah.
I'm not thinking about nothing.
Really? You have too many committed to already. You know what is that?
I do. Well, I just found out last night at the Christmas party that I dropped the ball and I didn't have any scarves for the charity for our friend Nancy, who's dropping off at, I think, her local church or shelter. So I'm trying to whip up a couple scarves for kids out of some charisma. And then I have some homespun, too. So these will probably be really quick to do because I'm going to crochet them. I can crochet these way faster than knit these scarves. But I did commit. Now, I committed to this before The Biggest Loser. So there's somebody on Instagram that I follow, and her ID is Knit for Comfort, Jen. And I believe she's from the East Coast. She was looking for somebody to do a test sample of a crocheted item for her, for when she's out at vendor shows, I guess, or yarn festivals. So I said I would do it. I think I said I would do it in October. I sent her the shawl that I want to crochet for her, and she dyed up the yarn. She's a yarn dyer. And she sent it to me this week in this little cute box. Ain't that cute? And the yarn is called, the colorway is called Deconstructed Fruity Pebbles. So here's what we have. And she's already given me the way that she wants the colors done in the shawl, which is really cool. This is her card. Knits for Comfort. And I'll have to let you guys know, like, she actually donates proceeds to cancer. But I'll have her blurb next week. I didn't bring it downstairs today. But if you want to follow her on Instagram, it's Knits for Comfort. So these are going to be wound up pretty soon. I believe these are DK, and it's 230 yards. But this is nice and squishy, too.
It's very, very soft. Yeah.
So I will be showing you this. This is like an ad, I guess. And then it's going to be a D part. I don't know how that's going to work. But it's going to be an add to the weight, but then I'm going to knit it up and it's going to depart.
For me, I don't even think
that would count.
Right. Because it's something where
I committed prior.
It's not for you.
Yeah. It's a sample. I'm making a sample for her.
Whatever is left over and you keep, maybe.
Right.
But I don't think that there's going to be a lot to add, but that's something that, you know, it's not for you. You're right. Knitting it for somebody else. So I don't know. Benita will need your help on that for, we'll get in touch with Benita to find out.
And then I also committed to crocheting a virus shawl for Kathy, who lives in Texas. I think Kathy lives in Texas. So I got the cone in the mail. I'll have to show you next week because there's only so much I can bring downstairs. So I'm going to start a virus shawl for her as soon as I finish a couple other things, but it's a cone, and I think the colorway is called denim. It was like denim or something like that. So that I did commit to doing during The Biggest Loser. Nothing I can do about that. I'm good with it. Okay. DIY.
So
I have nothing. I'm going to sit back and enjoy this.
We did a VKN.
A video yarny chat.
We did last week.
It was so fun.
It was so fun. And it was so cool being able to talk to folks across the pond. Big pond.
Or down in Tennessee.
South. And it was great being able to talk to you guys. We just had some technical challenges, but you guys were great even despite that. So we'll.
That's right. We can type.
Yeah, we can type. So that was really, really nice to get to know you guys just a little bit. And, yeah.
We're hoping to have another one.
Yeah. So
we will let you know there's an ear burn list or there's a thread on Ravelry, or if you're on YouTube and you want to know and you're a member of the group, I can put you on the list. But it was so nice to put a face with a name and see what other women are doing, in the world as far as knitting and actually talk to someone. Yeah. I mean, the technology is amazing that we can do that.
It is.
Yeah, it was just unbelievable. But we will do another video yarn chat.
So sounds good.
We will, and we will.
We will. And right after that, somebody taught me how to spin. So I had brought over my Aunt Joan, the wheel that Aunt Joan gave me. And somebody was very patient with me. And we sat there, and eventually I got this. Look at it.
I think they got that in Ann Arbor.
This was the last one we went to.
Is that a single? Or is it plied with another bob? That's a single, right?
Single.
Those are singles. Okay.
So you told me I had to something before I could ply it.
Yep.
So I'm still figuring it out, if you couldn't tell. So I got this one, and this was the one where you gave me the big puff.
I think that was from one of Susan's friends when we were in Ann Arbor. It was. Had the booth.
Yeah, and she was just trying to get rid of some of the tufts of
the little balls
that she had, and so she gave us a really good deal, and so
This is really nice. That.
And then when I went to Stonehenge Fiber in the summer, I ended up getting a bat of fluffy fiber. And
the wool?
It's wool. It's the same shepherd's wool that they sell and they're famous for. So I have this too. Right now it's just a single. It had to be stretched, apparently, before I can...
It's been soaking it, too.
Yeah, so it's been soaking, and then I'm going to ply it. Our friend Pat told us what you do is you wind it into a cake like this, and then you pull from the outside and the inside, and then you just spin it together, and then it's two-plied.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what that's called yet. So that's what I'm doing.
It's like barber poling.
Okay.
Like a barber pole.
So what was interesting is sometimes you to get, that's so cool.
It's Kool-Aid. It's grape Kool-Aid, red Kool-Aid.
Okay, so you guys got to see this.
I did this last year too, and I'm surprised that
it's really cool.
Still kind of bright. Not really my colors, but kind of cute.
So, I needed a...
Whoa. I think this chair needs to go to the curb.
Aren't you leaning back?
No. It's like going back. It's not on a lock. It's creepy.
Okay. Do you want to grab that chair while I'm talking?
No, go ahead.
I don't want you hurting yourself.
That's right.
So, when you're done spinning, you have to... I was sitting there spinning, and I'm like, I finally get it so I don't have to keep going like this with the wheel and it, using the feet. And I'm like, okay, I think I'm finally getting this. And then all of a sudden it stops really spinning that much or something. And I'm like, something's wrong. And then I see the string that makes the wheel go wrong. Boing! And I'm like, oh boy, it's a good thing that you said, if anything happens to that string, make sure you go out and get butcher's yarn.
And yeah, so, the butcher string. Because Pat told me that. And I'm like, really? The butcher string? Yeah. And she's like, yeah, butcher string.
So I ended up going to the butcher. They sent me to a specialty store where they sell knives, sharpening knives. I mean, it was really an experience. And so I found the butcher string, and they had like three or four different kinds. I'm like, oh, brother. And I asked them, and they said, oh, yeah, we got about 10 different kinds. What kind did they say that you needed? And I'm like, butcher string?
Yeah.
And they're like, oh. And when I got home, I ended up realizing I already had something that would work just fine. So I didn't
end up getting the butcher string.
Right. So the butcher string is thicker than what I needed it. So I don't know. But I was looking around that store, and they had so many different things that were just so cool. I'm like, oh, I can use this for when I start looming. I can use this for that, you know. And it's just, it was really a cool store. And then Sheila said that when you pull the stuff off of the wheel, you need one of these.
It's a knitty natty.
Okay.
And when you pull fiber off your wheel, not the stuff.
Whatever. I'll get there.
Oh, that's funny.
So, after going to the butcher interesting store, I ended up going to Ace Hardware, which I think that's more of a Michigan type thing. I don't think it's nationwide. It's a local hardware store. And they actually cut it down, the different pieces down to the size that I needed. I did this one 13 and a half, which I would suggest to go closer to like 12 and a half,
mm-hmm.
because it was a little bit longer than yours. And then these right here, it was supposed to be 7.5 inches wide or whatever. It's a lot more than 7.5 inches wide.
Yeah.
So mine's like big, but the biggest,
that's okay.
And this is,
you use red duct tape or red electrical tape?
Electrical tape. Mm-hmm. And the electrical tape was more expensive than buying the piping and the little
ends
and then the T-joint.
To make it pretty was more expensive than the unit.
And they don't have hot pink. What the heck is that all about? That's what I want to know.
Hot pink duct tape?
Electrical tape.
Oh.
You know, those guys, they just need to get over it. Now, I mean, sometimes us women want to use electrical tape and we want hot pink. Get over it. Make some hot pink. I'm sure it wouldn't be a bestseller.
Put your order in.
Yeah, I know, right? Okay, so I went over these.
I have no DIY.
Now, this is something I did like 2.5 years ago. And you wanted me to bring it.
Yeah. This was too funny. When we used to meet up at the local LYS, Debbie needed a body double because she was starting to make garments. And she wanted to place the garments on the body double to see how they would fit. But she's like, I'm not buying a form. I'm not buying that. So she came in one day with a big roll of duct tape. Was it two T-shirts? And she's like, here, help me. Duct tape me.
So here you go. It's, you know, it's a form, and you can put the little arms in there.
So actually, Debbie was wearing this T-shirt, and there was another person going around and putting duct tape all around this while Debbie was in this.
Yeah. And then what happens is after, if you do this, it is a great way to have the body double. It doesn't work so well if you gain weight afterwards, like I did, and I'm probably about 20 pounds heavier than I was at this point. But so gaining weight doesn't help. But take breaths. Make sure you keep your lungs full because this gets so tight and it doesn't really leave a lot of room for you to breathe. And then afterwards, what you do is the person cuts
up the back.
Yep, the back off. Now, what happens is when you're wearing, a tank top, and then the thing is when they cut, just make sure they don't cut your tank top off.
What'd you stuff that with?
Just regular fiberfill, just polyester, blah, blah, cheap stuff. And then you can, you know, just duct tape after to put it back up there. Yeah. So you just get an oversized t-shirt that you just don't really care, you know, you don't care if you lose.
Destroy it.
And then you just duct tape the crap, you know.
Make a body form.
Yep. I don't know. It's kind of weird hugging a body form that's for
yourself. You're hugging yourself.
Okay. So that was that. This table is getting clear on my side.
Is it?
Yeah, I keep throwing stuff off the table. Usually it's a little bit fuller on her side than mine.
Yeah.
Not so much today. So,
satellite store.
Okay, so for the satellite store, we ended up having a Christmas.
We had our Christmas party last night on Friday the 13th.
Yeah.
Because of the schedule of
everybody.
Yeah, of everybody.
And that's our knitting group.
What's our knitting group called?
Knitwits.
The Knitwits. Yeah, we've been the Knitwits for what, 7 years?
Something like that, yeah.
7 years we've been the Knitwits, I think.
Meeting every Friday or most every Friday and just whatever.
Going on field trips together.
Yeah. And we've, you know, if there's any way that you can join a local yarn store who has a Friday night knit along or whatever, it's amazing. I would have never met Sheila had I not wandered in the local yarn store and just, I'm like, oh, Friday night, that sounds fun. You know, and just hanging out. And I mean, Sheila might not have been my first choice for a friend. And some of the other ladies in the group might not have ever met them. And they have just enriched my life so much. We've walked through so much together. If there's any way that you can find a friendship or a group, and it doesn't even have to be around yarn, but just that you meet every week and get to know each other. I mean, it really is a big deal to have friends like Sheila. And so if you can find someone.
It's a good group of ladies that we have. I would have never met them otherwise.
Right.
I would have never met all the other ladies otherwise.
It's the strand that ties us all together. Okay, yeah.
But we had our Christmas party last night, and then we did our, what was that gift exchange called?
A white elephant gift exchange.
Oh, I don't like white elephant. I don't like it.
I loved it. I love them. My family's like, yeah, we don't want Debbie's junk. We don't want to do it. So what I do is I didn't get my act together for Christmas this year. I usually bring so much that it doesn't matter if they bring it or not. They still get a number and have to participate, and then they just get more of my stuff. So, but
either way, they're going home with your stuff.
They're going home with my junk. So for mine, look at this cute little bag. Merry Christmas. And it's like, whee! Yeah. I ended up getting some Nova Plantina Knitter's Pride, and I love Knitter's Pride. And so it's interchangeable. So this is the wire that it goes on.
Is that a blue cord? Oh, it is. That's cool.
Oh, it is.
That's nice. I've never seen a blue cord. That must be something new.
I like that.
Usually they're blue.
Black.
Or black.
Yeah, I like the blue.
The blue cord. That's cool.
That's really nice. And then some Godiva chocolate. And then a cool mug that says, I'm working on my PhD, projects half done in knitting.
That's cute.
It is so darling. So
that is really cute.
I really lucked out. I really did well on that. Yeah. And then the other two items that I got is I got some really cool socks.
Aww.
Just little owls. Speckles on the aren't sides. They? Yeah, they're sparkly. Isn't that great?
I love Christmas socks.
Yeah, they're so nice.
I wear Christmas socks all year long.
And then these are Oh, last time I just didn't do so well when I tried to explain it.
Oh, here, I'll show you.
I still don't. It's this thing right here, and it.
There you go.
Okay. Okay.
Yep.
So,
it's a needle keeper. I'm sure a lot of you have already seen these. Oop. Be nice if I line it up, right?
Oh, yeah. But I really need this type of thing for this, especially this assignment. So
it's a needle keeper.
Yeah, so then this way you can just go like that and you won't lose any stitches like what I was talking about earlier today.
Yeah, how you lost your stitches. That stuff.
Yeah, so that's something that you just put it like that and then it's good to go.
It helps. Yeah. It totally helps. I got my Christmas socks last night from Pat.
Ooh.
Look how cute. The little snowman.
And hearts.
I'll be wearing these to work this week. This is my second go around. My first go around was stolen.
Not by me.
Nope, Debbie didn't steal it. I'm not gonna
say stole that one.
I'm not gonna say who stole it because you know who you are. But my second go around was a yarn bowl, and I told everybody at the table they didn't want it because it was a broken dish. I said, "You certainly don't want this; it's broken." But this is pottery, or it's got a name on there, Barb LaSalle. Very nice; got a nice bottom on there, two holes. Very nice, my first yarn bowl. But yeah. The Christmas party was good. We ate good.
Oh, my gosh.
We laughed hard. It was fun. Yeah. It was a good Christmas party.
Yeah.
It was kind of weird because you're at work and you're like, I got to go to my Christmas party. And they're like, what? I'm like, yeah, it's Friday the 13th. I got to go to my Christmas party.
You know, it was a full moon.
Yeah.
Friday the 13th.
The crazies were out.
And then there was us having a Christmas party.
The crazies were out.
So
the last thing we have is we're going to continue this through the whole year. So yay. We're going to have another one.
Awesome.
Can you read it or you want me to read it? You want to try?
Yeah.
Okay.
I might pass it.
Okay.
If I get bored.
Okay.
I've yet to meet an absolute perfectionist whose life was filled with inner peace. The need for perfection and the desire for inner tranquility conflict with each other. Whenever we are attached to having something in a certain way better than it already is, we are almost by definition engaged in a losing battle. Rather than being content and grateful for what we have, we are focused on what's wrong and with something and our need to fix it. When we are zeroed in on what's wrong, it implies that we are dissatisfied, discontent. Whether it's related to ourselves, a disorganized closet, you know who that is, and you know what your stash is like. Disorganized closet, a scratch on the car, an imperfect accomplishment, a few pounds we would like to lose, or someone else's imperfection. The way someone looks at, behaves, or lives their life, the very act of focusing on imperfection pulls us away from our goals of being kind and gentle. This strategy has nothing to do with ceasing to do your very best, but with being overly attached and focused on what's wrong with life. It's about realizing that while there's always a better way to do something, this doesn't mean that you can't enjoy and appreciate the way things already are. The solution here is to catch yourself when you fall into your habit of insisting that things should be other than they are. Gently remind yourself that life is okay the way it is right now. In the absence of your judgment, and everything will be fine. As you begin to eliminate your need for perfection in all areas of your life, you will begin to discover the perfection in life itself.
Oh, that's cool. That makes sense. That totally makes sense.
It does. Mm-hmm. Doesn't really fit into, like, New Year's goals, though. But
no, but a lot of people, they expect, like,
I know someone who their towels have to be a certain way.
Oh.
You know, like, that's the, you know, you expect everything to be perfect. And it's, mm-hmm. it doesn't work that way. You're going to focus on that and you're going to miss life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is a good book. I like this
book. It's a very good book.
So we hope you like the little phrase for the day. Oh, I do have one more thing really quick before we go.
Of course.
I've added, what'd you say? Of course.
Of course. It wouldn't be a podcast without Sheila saying.
I've added a few more bags to Thank God for Bags on Etsy. And I just want to show you a few more that are going to be going up this weekend. So I'll just slide them across to Debbie. Ready? Which side do you like better?
Oh, my word.
There you go. We have butterflies. And thank you. Here's some wildlife. Do you like the wildlife?
Yes.
Looks like all the animals that you would see in Alaska. This is a cute little bag for, like, needles. Look. It's a pair of glasses.
Aww.
And then this is the last one for right now. And this is the birds.
Partridge in a pear tree.
Look. Oh. The little zipper pull is actually a bird sitting on a wire.
Aww.
So those will go up in the shop if you're interested. Thank you for subscribing. If you subscribe on YouTube, we're both on Instagram. And our links to Instagram are on our YouTube channel up there in the right-hand corner. If you have a comment, question, or concern, PM us, DM yeah. us,
yeah.
leave a comment.
Sheila's the complaint department.
Yeah, just for a little while longer. Just for a little while longer. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for watching. And I think that's all we have.
I think so, too.
I think so.
If not, we'll just talk about it next week.
Yeah,
or next
we will.
Time.
Take okay. care of yourself.
Yep, have a great week.
Bye-bye.
Bye.